ABC preempts its regularly scheduled programming for the following special, brought to you this Christmas morning by the Walt Disney Company.
Call out the holly.
Put up the tree before my spirit falls again. Fill up the stocking. We may be rushing things, but...
Put your eyes together. Merry Christmas.
Oh, we need a little Christmas.
Right this very minute.
My true love gave to me 5 golden rings.
4 calling birds,
3 French chefs,
2 Tweedledums,
and an 18th with a 4-3. Yes, we need a little Christmas right this very minute. Candles in the window, carols at the spinet. Yes, we need a little Christmas right this very minute. It's Christmas here at Disney World.
Coming to you live from Walt Disney World in Florida. Holiday greetings to all of America, Canada, South America, Europe, Australia, the Far East, and service men and women around the globe. It's the 6th annual Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. Join our hosts Joan Lunden and Alan Thicke, along with Regis Philbin, right here at Walt Disney World in Florida. And from Disneyland in California, join Sarah Purcell and family ties Scott Valentine for all the holiday magic and fantasy of a coast-to-coast Disney Christmas extravaganza. Share all the laughs and holiday cheer of a visit to Mickey's birthday land. Celebrate Christmas Caribbean style with Minnie and all her friends. Say hello to Oliver, Dodger, and Francis, and take a behind-the-scenes look at the making of Oliver and Company. Join family ties Scott Valentine as he previews Disneyland's great new thrill ride, Splash Mountain. Catch a sneak peek at the movie magic coming soon to the Disney MGM Studios theme park. All this and more is on its way.
Dashing through the snow. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright.
Oh, what fun it is to sing
the sleighing song tonight.
Yes, we need a little music.
Need a little laughter.
Need a little singing, ringing in the rafters. Yes, we need a little something happy.
Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by the Kissimmee-St. Cloud Resort Area, for the best room rates outside the gates of the Walt Disney World Vacation Kingdom. Premier Cruise Lines, the official cruise lines of Walt Disney World, bringing you the cruise and Walt Disney World Week. And Johnson & Johnson, where quality products for the American family have been a tradition for generations. Stay with us for all the excitement of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. We'll be right back.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the 6th annual Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. We hope you're having a wonderful Christmas wherever you're watching us from.
That's right. Merry Christmas, everyone. Can you believe it? We've been doing this parade now for 6 years, and I think you'll agree it's getting better each year.
Well, this year there's more excitement, more parade, more entertainment than ever before.
And more people watching. We are being seen in Hong Kong, Australia, Spain, United Kingdom.
Yes, and let's say Merry Christmas to the folks in my hometown country, Canada, and of course to our friends in Mexico. Joyeux Noël, mes amigos. That was a trilingual greeting. I think that's a parade record.
Très bien, Alan.
I can say fa-la-la-la-la in 10 languages.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you're seeing the Metropolitan Life blimp right now, and that is being piloted today by Joe Whalen from Hot Springs, Arkansas. And we should say that they're also the sponsor of the new Wonders of Life Pavilion that's being built over at Epcot Center. Right now, though, you know who's here with us today.
I think it's probably Regis.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Regis Philbin, he's standing by down on Main Street, USA. Regis, how's it going?
Going very well, and Merry Christmas to you, Alan, and to you, Joan. You can feel the excitement down here in the air as everybody's getting ready for the start of this big parade. Right, gang?
Yay! We're all here.
We all have our Disney jackets on, and here's somebody with a happy holidays. Where are you from?
Rehoboth Beach, Delaware.
And you come here often?
Every year since 76.
For Christmas time?
And twice a year. We were here in June.
You're a real Disneyophile, aren't
we
you?
We are.
Providence College?
Yes.
Yes. And here's another family. Families are beginning to dress alike down here. Where are you from?
Hawthorne Woods.
Good. And here he is with his mini cam, and here she is right here. Hi, how are you? And where are you from?
Winnipeg, Canada.
From Canada. Here's a family from where?
Massachusetts. Carolina.
Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Look at these two guys. They look alike.
Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
All right, fine. Anyway, who's your favorite Disney character?
Pardon me?
Roger Rabbit.
Disney character.
Mickey Mouse.
Roger Rabbit.
All right, you're going to see Roger Rabbit, you're going to see Disney Mouse, Mickey Mouse, and you're going to see them all, and over 300 Disney characters and performers in the most dazzling Christmas parade of them all.
Beautiful.
Yeah, and it looks like it's about to begin right now, so let's strike up the band.
You are listening to the Clemson University Tiger Band, the official marching band of Clemson University.
That's right. The Tiger Band is directed by Richard E. Goodstein, and they have 237 members. There's a waiting list for those flutes, Joan, because they're small and easy to carry in a parade. Those tuba players have to be wondering about their choice about halfway through this parade.
That's one? Right. It's a 1.2 mile parade route.
A big one. Now, on January 2nd, this band will be participating in the Florida Citrus Bowl game right here in Orlando when the Tigers meet the Oklahoma Sooners.
Walt Disney World first opens its gates in 1971. Thousands of guest bands have participated in something really wonderful. It's called the Magic Music Days program here at Walt Disney World. And schools from all across the country come and perform for the guests. They get to enjoy a lot of Disney fun and magic, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them. Great shot up Main Street there, and I can't think of a better way to start off a parade than with a hot band.
Well, they hardly ever start with a scene from your favorite sitcom, do they?
But that could be an idea.
It's an idea.
Absolutely. There is a lot more fun, though, on Main Street, so let's go back down and take a look at what's going on.
I can't see that.
All right, here comes the Merry Christmas banner.
Oh, now.
And you see Cinderella's castle right back there, and that's kind of the center of the whole kingdom.
Yeah, I missed that. That's a beautiful one.
And here we have the band, the fanfare trumpeters, led by Major Mike.
Mike Davis.
That's right. He's there every year with the fanfare trumpeters.
Those trumpeters have a lot of horn to blow over this 1.2 mile stretch. When they keep in shape, you know, they lift weights with their lips.
And the guy who's keeping everything in rhythm, the guy who plays the timpani.
It's Boom Boom. I think we should take a moment to salute all parents who were brave enough to buy drums for their kids for Christmas.
I really think you should have a set of those in your house. Be a good sport, Alan.
I do.
Now, just behind this band, there they are, the stars of the day. Mickey Mouse and the love of his life, Minnie Mouse. Hey, look who's there. Those are my little girls.
They must know somebody. How did they get such good seats?
That's Lindsay there waving in the red.
Uh-huh.
She's 5 and a half now. Jamie is 8. Little Sarah, who's 18 months. We didn't think she'd make it today in the carriage. She's watching from the room.
A couple Good Morning America hostesses in training, folks.
That's right. Oh, look at this guy. He's got his hat on. Hi, Mickey. Hi, Minnie.
Mickey, of course, celebrating his 60th birthday this year, and over 10,000 children from around the world came to Disneyland and to Walt Disney World in Florida to wish him a happy birthday.
That's right. He's not just popular in America, but all over the world. In fact, he went to Russia this year. He got to meet their national hero, Mr. the Bear.
That was made possible by the Gorbachev Glasnost policy, I think.
That's right. Year. Look who's here, Alan.
My favorite.
Cinderella. The reigning monarch, of course, of the Magic Kingdom.
Mm-hmm. Now, of course, that crystal coach, I hate to burst your Christmas bubble, but that's not really a crystal coach. That is a former pumpkin.
That's right. If you look very closely, you'll see the pumpkin vines that make up the coach's mm-hmm. frame. Isn't she beautiful? The little children's eyes light up along the street when they see her.
And, of course, those horses aren't really horses. They're mice.
That's right. Uh-huh. And there's her footman. The royal footman.
Always on hand to lend a helping foot whenever Cinderella needs it.
Ah, aren't they beautiful? Those are the court dancers, kind of twirling their way to the ball, wearing their finest satins and brocades and those beautiful hoop skirts.
Costumes that take months of work, designing and sewing, all for the Fairy Godmother designer label.
Yes, so the parade features over 300 costume entertainers. So if you average about 6 yards of material per costume, I think that comes out to over 2,000 yards of material. There's the royal band.
Mm-hmm. Do you have some favorite songs from Cinderella?
Yes, Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo, I think, has got to be one of my favorites.
From the verb to bibbidi.
That's right.
I bibbidi you bobbidi boo.
Yes. Here comes the Cinderella castle float.
The tallest float in the parade, 17 feet high, and it clears the garland on Main Street by just an inch and a half.
And there's the fairy godmother. She had to work hard to get that whole thing ready.
I think she's directing traffic there to make sure she...
And of course, Prince Charming is just waving to all of his fans down below.
It's a charming thing to do. And who do we have here?
Well, I think Pearl along the sides you see Perla and Susie mm-hmm. and Gus Gus and Jacques. They're all along the side there. And here comes the Royal Guard, the Knights of the Magic Kingdom on horseback.
Yes.
Kind of brings back the age of chivalry.
You know, my mother is here with me visiting from Toronto, and she wanted to do the Fairy Godmother shot this year.
She applied for that?
Yes, but had to go on the Fairy Godmother waiting list. But Merry Christmas anyway, Mom. Glad you're here.
All right.
Stay with us, if you will, for more of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade from Florida.
Coming up next, we've got Dumbo and all the characters from Jungle Book. Plus, join me for a very special visit to Mickey's birthday land to celebrate Christmas.
That's right. Mickey now has his own land in the Magic Kingdom.
And we have a great time there, and you will too, so stay right where you are. All right, welcome back to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, coming to you live from Walt Disney World in Florida.
It's a beautiful day here, and later we'll be going to Disneyland in California for a coast-to-coast Disney Christmas celebration. A lot of excitement going on right now on Main Street, so let's take a look.
And I think I see the Calliope coming down the street.
Mm-hmm.
This is the very same Calliope that Walt Disney had on opening day of Disneyland over 30 years ago. Still looks great.
This was built in London, England back in 1907.
There are no springs on that thing, so that's a very, very tough ride up there. You can see the Percherons pulling the Calliope.
Walt Disney loved horses, didn't he?
Oh, look who's here. It's Casey Jr., the locomotive, pulling his friends into town. That means Dumbo can't be far behind.
Dumbo was Walt Disney's favorite movie. Of course, he missed Teen Spiders from Outer Space.
All the clowns, a happy bunch of clowns.
Mm-hmm.
Did you ever dream of running away to the circus?
It never occurred to me, no.
No?
Well, you can smell the peanuts on my breath.
Oh, I'm sure that you can ride one of those, though, a unicycle, right? You do it all the time in your backyard.
I like to practice in the off-season. Yeah.
Look at that guy. That's what you call a clean act.
Yes. Usually when you see a clown on the street, he's making a sudden left turn in front of you. But
You know, there was a good reason, though, for circuses to come into town on a train. Not only did they get all the animals and everything to the big tent, but it also let everyone in town know that there was a circus. It was kind of like a big moving commercial.
It was a commercial, yeah.
Absolutely.
Now, don't worry, folks, about the fire. If you're familiar with the story, Dumbo will spread out his ears and fly down to safety. You can see that tiny little stewardess on his head there.
It's a good thing, because I don't think those guys are going to be much help to Dumbo.
His ears are on the frequent flapper plan. He's going to be fine.
I remember back in 1955, it was when Disneyland very first opened in California. My mom and dad took my brother Jeff and me to Disneyland, and Dumbo was my favorite ride.
You managed to get the whole family mentioned on this show, don't you?
Absolutely.
I only got my mother plugged so far. I'm going to work on that.
All right, here we're going to the great, great guys in the Jungle Book. Yeah. We've got Colonel Hattie there. Oh, look at that. Mowgli, the man cub. Of course, raised by the wolves after being discovered by a panther. That's some family tree, huh?
You remember the main law of the jungle, according to Ogden Nash.
What that?
Said, if called by a panther, don't answer.
Oh, gosh.
I didn't say it either.
All right, besides Colonel Hattie, you're going to see King Louie, the orangutan there, and Baloo Bear.
The Jungle Book was the last film of Walt Disney's career. Based on a book by Rudyard Kipling called Mowgli Stories.
That's available in the library, and children should go to the library and find it and read it. Yeah, it really is. Ah, the T-Bone Brass.
The Jungle Rock.
One of the silliest bands you'll ever see.
Gets lonely in the jungle. From the blimp now, what would Christmas be without a mechanical thing that doesn't work? And that's Herbie.
Herbie the love bug, an incorrigible little guy, but a big, big hit here and all throughout Europe. These guys have a lot of trouble with Herbie. Watch.
Need to work on traffic control here.
The movie, Herbie the Love Bug, of course, starred Dean Jones, Michelle Lee, Buddy Hackett, David Tomlinson. Of course, most of all, it starred Herbie. It's one of the top films, though, in 1969.
And, of course, the crowd loving every minute. Enjoying their Christmas morning here at Disney World. And the kids eating it up. I think this is Herbie the miniseries.
Oh, but a lot of fun. I think it's one of the most colorful parades we've ever had.
And still to come, a visit to a fabulous movie studio and theme park coming here to Walt Disney World in Florida.
Yeah.
The Disney MGM Studios, plus a visit to Disneyland in California with Sarah Purcell and Scott Valentine.
Right now, though, I want to tell everyone about my visit to Mickey's birthday land. It's a brand new land here in the Magic Kingdom, and a few friends and I went over there the other night to help Mickey get set for Christmas. We had such a ball. We saw Mickey's playground, his 60th birthday show, which is great, and we even got to see Mickey's house. It's so cute. It's really wonderful.
Look, it's Mickey's birthday land.
Yay!
Oh, you know what? We're not due till 8 o'clock. Shall we go look around?
Yeah! It's Mickey's playground.
Oh, come on, let's look. Come on, you guys. It sure is, and you know what? We have enough time to see the show before going to Mickey's house.
Come on, let's go.
Mickey!
Okay, shh. The show's about to start. I think Mickey's home now. Shall we go wish him a Merry Christmas?
Yeah!
Yeah! Come on.
Let's go.
Hey, remember, kids, when Mickey comes to the door, everybody sing.
Happy Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Hi, Mickey.
Hi, Joan. Come on in, everybody. Merry Christmas. Gosh, that was swell.
Merry Christmas, Mickey.
Oh.
Look, the whole gang's here.
Hi, Minnie.
Hi, Pluto.
Hi, Goofy. Hi, Donald.
I'll stop for a big Christmas parade.
I can't wait, but first we wanted to stop by and wish you all a very Merry Christmas and bring Mickey a present.
Well, I smell something cooking in the kitchen.
Almost done, Dale. Almost ready, Chip. Fill her up. Be careful.
You like the tree?
Pretty, isn't it? Yeah.
Is that a
I think
Joan,
so.
Here.
Oh, is that for me?
Merry Christmas.
Oh, huh? Nice.
Ooh.
Open it now? Okay. You guys, look. It's my size. That's great. I love it. Thanks, Mickey.
You're welcome.
I can't think of a nicer way to spend Christmas than with all my good friends. It's been so much fun.
Did we have fun or what? Did you see how nicely Mickey's tree was decorated? I love the star that Goofy put up on top. Mm-hmm. And I can't wait to wear my new nightgown. What do you think?
It's a Christmas fashion statement for you. You'll look like a walking candy cane in
there. Yes, I think
so. Striped and festive. It'll come in handy if you ever have to spend Christmas in jail.
No, I only want to be locked up here. All right, everyone, stay tuned. We're going to be right back with more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade from Florida.
Oh, there you can see us, Joan.
Absolutely.
Just to the left of the,
left of the
tree, yes. Welcome back to all the fun and excitement of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
There's the blimp, 193-foot MetLife blimp.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if they have a TV up there.
I don't know. But look who's on Main Street, USA.
Mm.
That is...
looks like...
The Blue Fairy.
Could it be?
Fairy.
Yes. Blue Fairy, who lives up on that wishing star. So when you make a wish, that's who you're wishing to.
That's right. She's from Pinocchio, of course, the movie that gave the world what you might call the Disney theme song, When You Wish Upon a Star.
Yes. Pinocchio, who said, read my nose.
Oh, no. When You Wish Upon a Star, of course, won the Oscar in 1940 for Best Song.
I didn't know that.
Oh, look at them there.
The bad guys.
Gideon and Foul Fellow.
Mm-hmm. They were the ones who took Pinocchio to Pleasure Island, where he almost turned into a mule, and that could spoil your whole day.
You bet. And there they are, Pinocchio and Geppetto. And, of course, Geppetto wished and wished for a little boy.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, the Blue Fairy made his wish come true.
Pinocchio de Bergerac. The sneeze that lasted a week. He's a happy fellow on Christmas morning. One of the great stories of all time.
Oh, and there's the bad guy, Stromboli, the mean puppeteer. He's the one who threw Pinocchio in a cage and wasn't going to let him out. Until Jiminy Cricket came along and got him out of that jam.
Pinocchio had a rough life in the early days.
Yes.
Remember Monstro the Whale?
Yeah.
Geppetto and Pinocchio got trapped in his belly. They later escaped. That's how the whale spelled relief.
Well, Stromboli still has some
all these
little
puppets.
Friends here
yes.
locked up.
Well, of course, to be freed, they need what Pinocchio had, a conscience to be their guide. Or a hacksaw.
Maybe Jiminy Cricket can help them out. There he is. Pinocchio's conscience, and he's very proud of the official conscience medal the Blue Fairy gave him for helping Pinocchio. Up, look at this.
Oh, yes.
Look at that guy.
Off to the beach now. Have a gnarly Christmas, dude. This is probably how they're celebrating out in California.
That's right.
We'll see later.
No, we're going to get your boys in here now. Do they skateboard?
My boys skateboard. They
Brandon,
do all
Robin.
Kinds of dangerous things. Yes, Merry Christmas, boys. And speaking of great skaters, and, you know...
Oh, look who's here. It's Pluto. And he's going up the ladder. He's going to come down the slide.
He's not a great skater. I was going to wish a Merry Christmas greeting to one of the great skaters of all time, Wayne Gretzky, and his wife, Janet. They just had a little baby girl last week, and my son was born on December 17th, so I know what a wonderful present that makes. It'll be the best gift ever.
You bet. I think they're on roller skates down there. They're skaters. They're cyclists. They're skateboarders.
It's a California Christmas, all right.
A little Beach Boys music, a little St. Nick. They're all hitting the beach. Oh, it looks like you're ready for a little Caribbean Christmas.
Well, yes, or Caribbean Christmas, as the case may be. I'm waiting for... They're going to do my favorite, Rudolph the Reggae Reindeer, and that's coming up moments from now.
All right, well, stay
you
right here.
Feel the palm trees sway.
Because we're about to visit Walt Disney World's brand-new Caribbean Beach Resort, where you do actually feel as though you're on a Caribbean island. Bright, bright colors. It's a really exotic setting. Sand and sea and... palm trees and beaches and a fabulous pirate's pool, complete with pirate's cannons that, you know, really fire. And it's all just minutes from Epcot Center. And I hear they have a great party going on. Let's listen.
I get a tan.
We love it here upon the island, where silly Goofy loves to ski. We like to dance all day on Christmas, singing carols by the sea. Come on, shake your body, Minnie, do the conga. I know you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, Minnie, do the conga. I know you can't control yourself any longer. Everybody, gather round now. Let your body feel that beat.
We're here. Welcome back to the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
Yes, we're coming to you live from right here in the Magic Kingdom in Florida. And can you believe we've got such beautiful weather? I love this weather.
Well, that's the way it's supposed to be here. I'll bet you it's beautiful at Disneyland in California,
right,
too. And I personally can't wait to see Santa on a surfboard.
That's right. Mrs. Claus getting a few rays.
Yes. I wonder if Donner and Blitzen bought a map to the stars home this year. We'll be going there shortly for Sarah and Scott Valentine.
But right now, it's time for a country Christmas with the Country Bears for a real Christmas hoedown.
You got your liver lips, your Big Al, and your shaker from the Country Bear Jamboree.
There they are. Ever been to Country Bear Jamboree?
I have. I loved it. This guy loves it.
I love that. I also love Hoop-Dee-Doo Review.
Oh, yes. They can dance. They can hoe down, hoe up, hoe sideways. They can hoe in any direction, these guys.
It always amazes me how many talented young people there are here in Disney World and Disneyland as well. It's really where a lot of young people get their start.
Yeah. Singing and dancing and dressing in Christmas colors.
Along with the scarecrows, I don't know if they're going to really scare anybody, Alan, but they sure have a life of their own, huh?
They don't look very frightening to me. Scarecrows remind you of Ray Bolger in The Wizard of Oz.
Oh, they sure do. Now, there's one of my favorite movies.
We have a showboat now sailing up Main Street. That boat is lost.
That's right. That boat, though, was designed and constructed in California. And it is a beautiful, beautiful float. Look who's up there. It's Donald Duck.
It is.
At the helm.
The Duck Man.
A rascible little duck.
Mm-hmm. Where are the kids? Huey, Dewey, and Louie?
Well, you always know that they can't be far. There they are, Huey, Dewey, and Louie, always around to give Donald a real hard time.
What about Daisy? The float wouldn't be complete without Daisy now.
She's back there on the back. A lot of the children here also on the float. A lot of young children from around the Florida area also perform here at Disney World.
You
great
know,
opportunity.
Daisy was not her real name.
It was?
Like many actresses, she changed her name. It was originally Donna Duck.
Donna Duck?
Yes, and she went Hollywood.
I don't know.
Became
somehow Daisy's
there she
better.
Is.
There she is. I'm glad Daisy stuck.
Or Donna, as I came to know her.
You know, there was a point where Donald actually became more popular than Mickey Mouse.
Well, maybe with Daisy. Beautiful floats. Beautiful weather. Hope you folks at home are having as good a Christmas morning as we are.
Ah, isn't that great? Christmas time is such a magical time of the year everywhere, but even more so, I think, right here in the Magic Kingdom. All the shops are beautifully decorated. The tree is spectacular.
And I look forward to being here during the holidays.
I know,
this is
too.
A fun place to be. Where else could you see dancing reindeer and dancing snowmen and dancing Christmas trees?
And
it's
don't
like
forget,
one big aerobics class.
Don't forget Santa Claus.
Uh-huh. Lots more to come. Right now, we're going to see what's happening down on Main Street with Regis Philbin. Reg!
Hi, Alan. Hi, Joan. Hi, Alan. How you doing
Hi.
Up there?
Morning.
Spectacular day. It really is, as you were saying earlier, and a spectacular crowd, too. One of the biggest I've ever seen down here. Morning, everybody.
Morning.
How's the parade so far?
Fantastic.
We have the youngest member of the audience with us right here. This little baby is 3 months old. It's Richie, our cameraman's daughter, running our Steadicam, and this is the mother, Glenda. And 3 months old and enjoying it, right?
Very much
yeah.
so.
Staying awake for everything?
Everything. Enjoying every minute.
Funny, the cameraman was wearing this on his head last year. Anyway, have a wonderful day
Merry
today.
Christmas.
Now, look at this. We have a whole gang here from New Jersey. I don't know. Is this one family?
No!
Seven families, all friends and families and so on. And they all spell out, New Jersey says what? Gosh, Mickey, I'm sure I heard that. All right, now listen, gang, we'd like you to sing a little Christmas song. Is everybody good voice today?
Yeah.
Let's sing this song. We wish you a... Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Shouldn't have rehearsed them earlier. We wish you a Merry Christmas. Ready? One, two, three.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Not bad, but we can probably do a little bit better than that. If you'd really like to have a great rendition of We Wish You a Merry Christmas, just listen to this.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
Good tidings we bring to you and your kin.
Good tidings for Christmas
and a Happy New Year.
Now bring us a figgy pudding.
Now bring us a fig pudding.
Now bring us a figgy pudding.
And bring some out here.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas, everybody!
Welcome back to Walt Disney World's merriest Christmas parade ever live here in Florida. We're having a great time, and in just a few minutes, we're going to be joining Sarah Purcell and family tie Scott Valentine out in Disneyland in California.
Yes, well, it's 3 hours earlier there, so we couldn't get them up too late for the beginning of the parade. This is the first time ever that the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade is coming from both Disneyland and Walt Disney World.
It's a great way to celebrate the holidays, Disney coast to coast.
Before we join them, though, we want to go back down to Main Street.
That's right.
And check in on some of the holiday excitement here, and that includes...
the guys from Sherwood Forest.
Yes.
Forest, Robin Hood and Maid Marian.
A lovely couple.
Robin Hood, of course, who robs from the rich and gives to the poor.
Except in Beverly Hills, where he robs from the rich and gives to the rich. They have their own legend, don't they?
There in the green, you can see Not-So-Little John. You can tell how he got his name.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got...
what about Friar Tuck?
That's right.
Yes. A good friar trying to keep everyone in line. A chorus line in this case.
You always have to look hard for Friar Tuck, because he's always back there in the middle of all the wenches.
There,
see,
yes.
I told you, he's always in the middle of those wenches.
Well, it's a tough job, but some friars got to do it. There they are. Lovely wenches. Encouraged to be wenches, no doubt, by Robin's nemesis, Prince John. Where is Prince John? Probably skulking in the forest somewhere.
Well, they're all dancing to the music of the Funky Monks.
I think I just saw Punk Funk Monk. Goodbye to Prince John, the royal rat.
Look,
we have a
who's
dog
here.
Catcher now.
That's right. I don't know who's catching who there.
Yes.
There's a lady ahead of her time, Cruella de Vil. She kind of patented that new wave look when she started 101 Dalmatians back in 1961. Some hair, huh? He just can't get that dog in there, can he?
Remember in 101 Dalmatians where the pups used to sit around the TV set and they watched their favorite TV star dog? Here's some trivia for it. Now, what was the name of that dog?
What?
Thunderbolt.
Oh, yeah. Very good.
I think that's now a wine, but it used to be a dog.
Ah, oh, there's a magical feeling in the air. Mary Poppins on her way. There's Bert dancing.
The penguins.
Yeah.
They came in formal attire this morning.
Out for a jolly holiday, of course.
How about the song?
Chim Chim Cheree. You know, there's another song. That's another song that won an Oscar for Best Song.
And a spoonful of...
sugar? My kids always love that song. And can you say it? Super...
Keller...
Fragilistic... Expialidocious. There we go.
I never get that.
There's the Curly Band providing the music today for Mary Poppins.
Curly Band is so named for their costumes on those buttons.
And there she
Mary,
is.
Mary Poppins prepping. And the chimney sweeps.
Of course, Mary Poppins was played by Julie Andrews. That was her first screen role, earned 13 Academy Award nominations and 5 Academy Awards. Starred, of course, with Dick Van Dyke. Really a great classic. Has been seen in our house, I can't tell you how many times.
Every day.
Yes, almost.
Now, these guys can dance, too. There they are, stepping up. Of course, they get a lot of practice. There's not much room for chimney, not much work for chimney sweeps in the off-season.
Woo, a little lift there. That was great. We've got a lot more Christmas surprises in store for you, though.
Including the toy soldiers, plus a visit to Disneyland. So stay where you are. We'll be right back.
Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by Premier Cruise Lines, the official cruise lines of Walt Disney World, bringing you the cruise and Walt Disney World Week. Johnson & Johnson, where quality products for the American family have been a tradition for generations. And the Kissimmee St. Cloud Resort Area, for the best room rates outside the gates of the Walt Disney World Vacation Kingdom.
That's the Grand Floridian Hotel, the brand new one, and I got to stay there this time. Joan,
it is a beautiful, beautiful new hotel here.
It was so nice I didn't even steal any towels.
And that's the shot, of course, from the MetLife blimp, and there's the Magic Kingdom. And can you see us right behind a tree right there?
There we are, flanking Mickey.
Hey, welcome back, everyone.
Yes, Merry Christmas. We hope you're having a wonderful morning. Coming up, a behind-the-scenes look at the making of Disney's latest animated feature, Oliver and Company.
That's right. Oliver is a new twist on an old tale, Oliver Twist. Oliver is the orphan kitten who was taken in by a pack of pickpocket dogs headed by Dodger, the coolest dog in town.
Now, the music is just terrific with voices like Billy Joel as Dodger. They have Huey Lewis, Bette Midler, Cheech Marin, how could you miss? Of course, it's a wonderful soundtrack. Here's a backstage look at how Disney creates all that animated magic.
Now it's always once upon a time in New York City.
Well, Oliver, of course, was derived in a very general sense from Dickens' story of Oliver Twist, which down at its heart is a story about looking for love and looking for a family and finding it. And I think that kind of a universal, basic storyline is what's kept it around for a long, long time.
What's different about it is it's given a contemporary setting in a large metropolis. So the challenge is making that look fun, make it look like it'd be a nice, fun place to run around and be a dog and jump on trash cans, jump on cars, jump around and have some fun in the town. And I think we succeeded in doing that.
But to me, the difference between Disney animation and any other kind of animation you would see done elsewhere is character. It's that the characters are believable, they're real, they're genuine.
Now, how'd you find this place, Cat?
I followed this dog.
He's lying.
You start with a drawing of a character in the story. You have a character, say it's a chihuahua. So you do drawings of a chihuahua. Then you look at those drawings and you talk about his personality, what traits he has. Traits like your cousin Jimmy or something that you go, yeah, that guy behaves just like a little Brett that I know down the street or something like that.
And then another aspect that comes into play really strongly, not only in design but in the development of the character as a whole, is the voice of that character.
Yeah, well, they had an idea of they wanted a chihuahua, and so they had a kind of preliminary sketches, and then when I came in and started doing the voice, and then they go, oh, so they start fine-tuning it so that it's a really strange metamorphosis that the character starts looking a little bit like you, would if you were a chihuahua.
Look, Bart.
Hey, keep it down, guys. The game's on.
Oh, Bart, that's right.
Bette Midler, you know, loved the idea of doing it. And Richard Mulligan and Roscoe Lee Brown. And, you know, Cheech Marin was... We can't keep him out of the animation building now. He is that character. He's like, get out of here, Tito. You know, he wants to do every movie now.
Hey, man, check it out, huh?
I think one of the great fun things we've been watching in recent years is turning artists loose on computers and watching what comes out of it. The computer in Oliver gave us all of the cars that you see going behind the street. It gave you the subway tunnels and the subway trains. It actually manufactured Fagin's trike, and the trike actually became sort of a little character of its own because it had a lot of kind of fun movement to it.
But it gives a whole new dimension to animation. You have a whole new feeling of texture moving around something as you do in real life, rather than just a flat painted background.
It's something we could have never done 20 years ago.
I mean, we'll have shots in the future, thanks to computers, that'll just give you something you've never seen such depth before in your life, and without 3D glasses on. It's really exciting. It's fun. It's a brand new toy, and we're glad we've got them to play with.
Well, animation, of course, is the heart and soul of this company. And to now be back here and look at us with this commitment to making a new animated film every year, which we're very much on track to do, that's an enormously rewarding feeling.
It's just fantastic. It's fun. There are so many pictures in development. We all have a lot of ideas, and today at Disney, there's a chance to use those ideas. You know, it's just a great time to be here.
Absolutely positive.
And there they are now in Poison, making their way up Main Street.
That's Dodger, the leader of that band of pickpocket dogs. Really an old softy at heart.
And you see all the other characters up there. I see the little purple one. That's Georgette, pampered poodle.
Little Jenny with her, who escaped the kidnappers with everybody's help.
And there over on the other side, I think we can see Tito, a hot-blooded chihuahua. And Oliver, of course, is that little orphaned kitten.
Francis, the bulldog.
The very highbrow bulldog.
Like the bouncer.
Georgette up there dancing away.
You said pampered. She got too close then.
Oh, absolutely. She has so much culture, you know. Oh, well, the parade is working its way. You know, it comes through Frontierland and past Cinderella's Castle and then right down Main Street. And it's starting to feel an awful lot like Christmas. Do you know what that means, Alan?
Well, it probably means that the toy soldiers and Santa's elves are on their way. Let's go back to Main Street and see who's leading the way.
The toy soldiers. You can always hear these guys coming a mile away, I'll tell you. Of course, from Babes in Toyland. I bet you a lot of children watching this morning would like to be in Toyland. Some houses they probably are in Toyland.
Yes, yes. 32 toy soldiers marching today.
A shot there once again from the MetLife blimp. And of course they are sponsoring, you know, that new big Wonders of Life pavilion that's going up over in Epcot. There's so much construction in this place, it's unbelievable. Two new hotels are going up, and the big Disney MGM Studios are going up.
This is real wood they're marching in, by the way. Wooden heads and... remarkable bit of choreography and precision to not only move all that wood along 1.2 miles of parade route, but blow trumpets and
play instruments. And look at this, they really are playing all the instruments. Babes in Toyland was released at Christmas time in 1961. It starred Ray Bolger and that very famous Mouseketeer, Annette Funicello. And by the way, everybody, there is going to be a Mickey Mouse Club show back on the air in the spring. They've been canvassing all across the country and got a lot of talented young kids, and they're starting
to change. It's about time.
Yeah, it really is.
It would be tough to top Annette, you know. Her ears are in the Disney Hall of Fame.
That's right. Look at the blocks here. I think all these blocks spell out Merry Christmas if you look real close. Raggedy Ann and Andy.
Yes. You know, the first dolls, Raggedy Ann and Andy dolls, had big candy hearts inside, but they tended to melt.
I would imagine
So the manufacturers switched to cardboard hearts.
That's when they started painting the little I Love You, right?
Yes. I dated a couple cardboard hearts.
Yes, I'm sure. There's the baby doll with that sucker. Could take you a whole year to eat that sucker.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here are the gummy bears. Let's see if you do it this year. Can you name all the gummy bears, Alan?
I was just learning Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen, and then you made me learn Happy and Grumpy and Dopey and Sneezy.
But can you do the gummy bears?
Let's see. There is Tummy, Zummy, Sunny, Cubby, Gruffy, Grammy.
You got it, kiddo.
I'm now a certified gummologist. Santa's elves have certainly been busy making all of the toys. And get some gift ideas here. Remember, only 364 shopping days left for Christmas.
That's right. Look at all the elves there, putting their little teddy bears.
Uh-oh.
There's the gingerbread. This is the high cholesterol unit.
Yes. You know, the gingerbread was said to have been invented by a Greek baker about 5,000 years ago. I have a bit of a sweet tooth, you know, Joan.
Well, there's enough here to satisfy you, I think.
I'm putting an addition on my gingerbread house. I'm adding a shortbread wing next to it. Peanut butter basement.
Hey, there's Goofy. He managed to work himself there into all the
gingerbread.
Hey,
sure.
Chip and Dale. And how do you tell them apart?
Chip is called Chip and
no,
Dale.
Chip
is called...
has got one tooth and Dale has two teeth.
Well, then Dale eats less candy from these floats.
And I see Tigger the Tiger down there. I see Winnie the Pooh and Eeyore. They're all great friends, though. And look,
there she
is.
Mrs. Santa Claus.
I'll bet she's glad.
Oh, yes, she could use a hiatus for a week or two. Look at all that candy, followed by the American Dental Association.
That's right. We've got a lot more. We've got Santa Claus coming up, so you stay right where you are. We'll be right back.
Do you suppose Mickey goes to a rodentist? I'm sorry, but 4 years... Welcome back to this Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade from the Magic Kingdom in Florida. We're having a very nice time here. Thank you very much.
And out in Disneyland in California, they're also celebrating Christmas. You know, for over 30 years, Disneyland has brought that special Disney magic to California.
Well, that's where it all began.
And, of course, Disneyland is smack dab in the center of all that California sun and fun.
I didn't know that. You mean they have surf and sand and girls and not necessarily in that order?
Is that a multiple choice question?
I think it's a multiple choice answer, yes. Something for everyone in California. But before we go to Sarah Purcell and Family Ties Scott Valentine, who are standing by at Disneyland, here's a little something to get you moving to that California beat.
Purcell and Family Ties Scott Valentine for a closer look now. And Merry Christmas, Sarah.
Well, thanks, Joan. Merry Christmas to you, too, and to you at home. You know, it's hard to believe, before Disneyland opened 33 years ago, this all used to be orange groves. But now, as Joan said, Disneyland is right in the middle of all the Southern California action. But Disneyland's where it all began. It's the original. And there's no denying it is magic. 33 years old and getting better every day. You know, every time I come here, there's something new to see. Like now, during the holidays, Main Street is beautifully decorated, up and down with holly and ribbons and bows. And down in Town Square stands a huge 50-foot Christmas tree. Can you imagine decorating that? Well, out on Main Street joining me is someone who just might be crazy enough to try. One of the stars of Family Ties, Scott Valentine. Hey, Scott.
Hello, Sarah.
Is everybody having a good time down there?
Everybody is having a great time. Right, everybody? Yeah! And Disneyland's very own Merry Christmas Parade is making its way towards us. And everybody is very much in the holiday spirit. Are we?
Yeah!
But I gotta tell you, my mind is somewhere else. You see, Disneyland has got this brand new attraction called Splash Mountain. Now, it's a log flume ride that everybody says is going to be unbelievable. I mean, it's like the Pirates of the Caribbean, the Matterhorn, and Space Mountain all rolled into one. And what I hear is it's the highest, the fastest, the steepest, the longest, the wettest log flume ride of any in the world. And now get this. It's not open to the public yet, but I get to be the first one to ride on it. Eh? Huh? Does anybody want to come along with me? Yeah! All right. Well, Sarah, we're going to find out who wants to come with me, and then we'll be back, and you'll find out who.
Okay. Okay, Scott. Well, it looks like he's got his hands full. Meanwhile, Disneyland's very Merry Christmas Parade has thrilled millions of Disney guests since 1955, bringing to life the fantasy of Disney characters from classic animated films. And in just a minute, we'll meet the Grand Marshal of the Parade, a character in his own right, and one of this year's biggest movie stars. First, what better way to begin a parade than with a marching band? The Rose Bowl-bound Southern California Trojan Marching Band, no less. They're over 200 strong, looking great coming down Main Street. They're under the direction of Dr. Arthur C. Bartner, and of course they're marching to the tune of Everything's Coming Up Roses. Let's listen. Up roses, because this January the 2nd you can see them in the Tournament of Roses Parade, as well as the Rose Bowl football game, where the University of Southern California will take on the University of Michigan. They're always an award-winning band. You can hear why and you can see why. You one of this year's biggest movie stars? Well, here he is, the Grand Marshal of our parade, straight from Toontown, Roger Rabbit. Roger, of course, became an overnight star in one of this year's top films, Who Framed Roger Rabbit? And now Roger's celebrating his first Christmas at Disneyland, and I'd say he's doing it in style with his very own Christmas show, which can be seen at his very own Christmas village here at Disneyland. Hi, Roger, how you doing? And here's another Disney favorite, Snow White, standing at the wishing well, wishing for her prince to come. Snow White was given a special Academy Award, one full-size Oscar, and seven little miniature ones. And speaking of which, what is Snow White without her seven heroes, huh? Can you name all of the dwarfs? Last year, to commemorate the 50th anniversary of Snow White, Disney celebrated all year long with parades and shows and a special re-release of the film classic. We're going to take a break, but when we come back, we'll have more of Disneyland's very Merry Christmas Parade, including Peter Pan and Alice in Wonderland, and plus Scott Valentine down on Main Street. Hi, and welcome back. More of Disneyland's Very Merry Christmas Parade is coming our way. You know, earlier, Scott Valentine told us that he gets to be the first one to ride Disneyland's new thrill attraction, Splash Mountain. Now, Splash Mountain brings to life the tales of Br'er Rabbit, Br'er Bear, Br'er Fox, and all the characters from the Disney classic Song of the South. And it includes 105 audio animatronic figures. Scott, you lucky dog. That sounds like a great time. Are you finding some folks to go along with you?
Oh, Sarah, I'm finding too many people to go with me. I'm overwhelmed. Everybody wants to go, right? You know, though, I can only take a few people with me, so I'm going to have to ask a few questions and be a little selective here, huh? But a few will be able to go. How about, let's ask this young lady right here. What's your name?
Dandy.
Now, Dandy, the last drop on Splash Mountain is over 5 stories. Can you handle drops like that?
Yeah.
And do you scream very loud?
Yeah.
All right, there's one good choice, huh? And let's ask this lady right here. Now, you get going over about, say, about 40 miles per hour. Can you handle that speed?
Sure.
Are you sure?
Yep, I'm sure.
All right, well, Sarah, you know, as you can see, I've got lots of people to pick from here. I'm going to have to mull it over a little bit. We'll go back to the parade and you, and when I make my decision, we'll come back.
It's a tough decision, isn't it, Scott? I know.
It's hard.
Somebody's got to do it.
Somebody's got to.
Thank you, Scott. And away we go in Never Never Land with Peter Pan, that wonderful story of a little boy who refused to grow up. There's Wendy and the Lost Boys with John playing Follow the Leader.
We won't be home till morning because he told us so.
And Mr. Smee trying to get away from the crocodile.
We sing yo ho, yo ho. We sing it whether we come or go, because that's the only song we know. The pirates sing on ships. Yo ho, yo ho, yo ho, yo ho, yo ho. Oh, a pirate's life is a wonderful life, a romance.
And there's a shipload of swashbuckling pirates.
The life of a pirate for me. Oh, the life of a pirate for me.
Gosh, look at the sword fighting. Watch out. We've got the Queen of Hearts barking orders to her playing card henchmen. Ooh, she looks like she got up on the wrong side of the bed today. Oh, dear. And there are the famous rose trees with the white roses that the Queen of Hearts has ordered to be painted red.
Disney Town.
There's the rabbit checking his watch. Uh-oh, uh-oh. Boy, it looks like old habits are hard to change.
I'm late for a very important date. No time to say hello, goodbye, I'm late, I'm late, I'm late, I'm late. And when I wait, I lose the time I save. My fuzzy ears and whiskers took me too much time to shave. I run and then I hop, 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 I wish that I could fly. The danger if I dare.
Incidentally, Alice in Wonderland was the first Disney animated film to use celebrity voices, with Ed Wynn as the Mad Hatter, Sterling Holloway as the Cheshire Cat, and Jerry Colonna as March Hare. Come back, we'll have more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade, including the Disneyland employee choir. Plus, Scott Valentine is going to show us who's going to ride Splash Mountain with him right after this. Hi, and welcome back to the Very Merry Christmas Parade, Disneyland style, of course. Scott Valentine ought to be heading over to Splash Mountain pretty soon, but his problem is that everybody wants to go ride with him. Scott, we're all getting anxious. Now, how are you ever going to make this decision?
Oh, hey, Sarah, obviously I can't take everyone with me, huh? So I figured it out. You know, a thrill ride like Splash Mountain really brings out a lot of emotion that people don't normally show. So what I'm going to do is just pick people that I'm very comfortable with, all right? Such as, how about this beautiful lady right here? What's your name?
Lisa.
Lisa, do you like thrill rides like Splash Mountain? Let's hear your scream, huh?
Ah!
Not bad, not bad. And how about this guy right here with Mickey on, huh? Now, you know this last drop is about 5 stories down. Can you handle it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah? And let's hear your Splash Mountain scream. Not bad, not bad. Well, Sarah, obviously the choice is going to be a tough one. Why don't we go back to you in the parade, and when we come back, I'll have the people all picked out.
Well, I guess we'll find out in a few minutes who's going to ride Splash Mountain with Scott. Meanwhile, we're going to take you back to more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade. And here comes Fantasia. To the music dance of the horns, this is Fantasia. Bringing to life the wonder and magic of the 1940 classic film. Perhaps Mickey Mouse's most memorable film role is the Sorcerer's Apprentice. Look at the ostriches. There are the alligators. You know, Fantasia was a very progressive film for its time. Originally, it was not a critical or box office success, and yet it went on to win an Academy Award for special innovation in sight and sound. Deservedly so, I have to say. Now, Christmas is never complete without gathering family and friends to sing a few Christmas carols. And what could be better than joining the Disneyland family for some caroling? In this case, the Disneyland employee choir. They're singing Oh, What a Merry Christmas Day from the animated film Mickey's Christmas Carol.
Here's all the teacher's friends who say, Very Merry Christmas!
Very Merry Christmas!
Very Merry Christmas!
Very Merry Christmas! Oh, what a Merry Christmas Day!
Now, only with the magic of Disney can you have a snow-covered Christmas in Southern California. Look at the beautiful dancers. Aren't they gorgeous? Christmas at Disneyland has that special magic it's found nowhere else. And where else but Disneyland could you find penguins ice skating on a beautiful warm day like this? But there they are. And dancing snowflakes, too. All sparkly. We're finally going to get to see Splash Mountain. It's Disneyland's brand new attraction. In fact, it's not even open to the public yet. But Scott Valentine gets to be the first ever to ride it. Now, Scott, let's see, who's going to go with you?
Oh, hi, Sarah. Let me see. Over here, we have Linda and Lisa. And behind me
Scott.
Is Sin. Here's Marge.
Scott.
And here's Jody.
Scott.
Yes, Sarah?
I can't help but noticing they're all girls.
Well, of course. I'm no dummy here. I mean, if Splash Mountain is as thrilling as they say it is, everybody's going to be holding on real tight and screaming and squeezing, you know, and
oh,
I don't want to miss any of that.
I see.
Uh-huh. So, ladies, are we ready to go?
Yeah.
All right. We'll see you later. Come on. We're here. We're ready to ride Splash Mountain.
But the gnome.
I mean, no. I was told that we could be the first to ride Splash Mountain, and we're ready to go.
Well, it's not open yet. I'm sorry.
Oh, hey. I'm sorry, you guys. You know, I don't know what happened.
Of your own free will, and you're zipping in a flash on a daring dash down a waterfall so rapid that you go splish-splash.
Splash Mountain,
zippity-doo-dah.
Splash Mountain,
zippity-ay.
My oh my,
swip-swip-swip-swip-swip.
Wonderful day,
swip.
Splish-splash,
plenty of sunshine,
swip.
Splish-splash,
in my way,
zippity-doo-dah.
It's gonna be a big drop.
Well, I hate to say it, but it's time for us to leave you from Disneyland. While Scott makes his way back here, I'd just like to thank you for joining us and hope you're all having as merry a Christmas as we are.
Sarah.
Oh my gosh, did you ride Splash Mountain?
I'm not sure what happened, but whatever it was incredible. And I definitely picked the right people to go with me.
Yeah, I noticed.
Mm-hmm.
But listen, we have to say goodbye now.
What?
Yeah.
No, goodbyes. I'm having too much fun. We can't go.
I know, me too.
No.
But now we're going to send the folks back to Joan and Alan at Walt Disney World. So for all of us here, Merry Christmas
and Happy New Year!
And welcome back to Walt Disney World in Florida, and thanks to Sarah and Scott.
Regis Philbin is about to take us behind the scenes at the new Disney MGM Studios theme park.
Regis?
On October 1st, 1971, Walt Disney World introduced Disney Magic to Florida with the opening of the Magic Kingdom. That was just the beginning. On October 1st, 1982, Epcot set to hail the dawn of a new Disney era with Future World and World Showcase. Come this spring, Walt Disney World will unveil its third theme park. I mean the biggest project since Epcot Center. The Disney MGM Studios bringing you movie magic and excitement unlike anything you've ever seen. The Disney MGM Studios, really two attractions. One of them is a theme park, the other an actual working studio complete with a back lot. This street, part of the studio theme park, is Hollywood Boulevard circa 1940. And behind me is the incredible replica of the Chinese theater. Inside these doors is the great movie ride, where you will find yourself in the middle of some of Hollywood's most famous scenes. From encounters with aliens, gangster shootouts, to visits with great old friends, the great movie ride lets you become part of all the magic and excitement of the movie. This is Catastrophe Canyon, where you find yourself in the middle of all the action, from giant explosions to great floods. Oh no, did I say floods? Wasn't that incredible? I mean, just fantastic. I love that kind of stuff. Who's doing the sound effects around here anyway? Just the right sound effects can make or break a film. At the Disney MGM Studio Tour, you'll be able to try your hand at creating all those special sounds you hear in films and on TV. Watch out! This is a rough one. Gotta stay alive. Gotta get through this storm somehow. Ah, come on, I fooled you, didn't I? There's no storm. Just some more movie magic. Really genius, isn't it? And that tugboat you thought you saw me in was actually a miniature. Now you can see how all this magic is created at the special effects tank show. The name Disney has always stood for great classic animation. At the magic of Disney animation, you'll see how animated features are created. Did you know that it took over 700 artists and storymen nearly 6 years to create the Disney classic Cinderella? Here you'll see everything from original concept to animators at their drawing table, to pencil tests, and into final production. And that's just the start of the excitement. Behind me is the actual working studio where you'll get to see films and TV shows as they're shot. In fact, production is already in full swing as TV shows and movies do their location filming here. Boy, I feel like I never left New York. This is part of the back lot, the New York Street. I'm standing here on Soundstage 2, which is one of three sound stages on the Disney MGM Studios. Inside, on overhead catwalks, you'll be able to catch all the action as it takes place. In fact, you'll see behind the scenes on everything it takes to create great movies, including a visit to the world's largest working wardrobe. You'll get a first-hand look at everything that goes into making a great movie or TV show, the sound, the pictures, and the music. Now that's what I call a good-looking guy. From Hollywood Boulevard to the New York Street, the magic of animation to the art of costuming, special effects, sound effects, Catastrophe Canyon to the great movie ride. Be a part of it all, the world of movie magic, this spring at the new Disney MGM Studios in Florida.
Ah, that's great. The Disney MGM Studio theme park is going to be great. It's going to really be the best of Hollywood here in Florida, and it opens this next spring.
It certainly does. And for more, Regis, who seems to be everywhere, yeah. He's like Tinkerbell, that guy. He's down on Main Street. Let's see what he's up to.
All right, Alan, here's Tinkerbell. Yeah, you know, there are a lot of people down here on Main Street, and most of them are wearing Disney T-shirts and Disney sweatshirts and so on. But there's always one guy who keeps you in touch with reality. And here he is. This is our guy today. This is Mr. Reality. This is what 40 looks like. Let's just call him 40-something, okay? Anyway, nice to see you, pal. Hi, everybody. How you doing? Are you having a great time today? What are you, look, every crowd has its own Christmas tree. This is today's Christmas tree, right? What do you got in here, anything?
Oh. That's my sweater for tonight.
Oh, he's got a sweater for tonight. He's going to be here all day. Hope you have a wonderful Christmas day, everybody. Yeah, a lot of excitement down here, but lots more to come. And right now, over at the castle, there is a great Christmas show ready to begin. So let's go over and catch the fun, okay?
Come on, we're going for a sleigh ride.
thump, giddy up, thump, thump, giddy up, thump, thump, giddy up. Just hear the sleigh bells jingling, ring, ching, jingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Outside the snow is falling,
jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Come on, it's lovely weather,
oh, I'm glad to hear it's too late. It's horse, open sleigh.
Hold it.
It's not a six-horse open sleigh.
You're right.
It's a Frosty the Snowman open sleigh.
No.
It's a six-horse, one snowman sleigh.
Did you see those kids kicking like that? Those are actually school children from right here in Florida. They do a great job.
They do a terrific job. And coming right up, you better watch out, Santa Claus. Red suit, white beard.
The whole thing. We'll be right back.
Welcome back, everybody. Merry Christmas to you. We hope you're having a great Christmas, and I guess if they are, we are.
That's right. It's been wonderful, and I know everyone here at home and around the world is watching and having a great time, but the real big moment that everyone has been waiting for, the very merry finale here at Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade is about to begin.
Uh-huh.
And we can always tell when we see the snowmen, the snow people, I guess
That's
we should say.
That's your first clue.
Those snow people better be careful on a gorgeous day like this in Florida. They might melt. But they look like they're in great shape.
It's probably the power of suggestion. As long as Frosty doesn't know, he'll just have a snowball.
Oh, very good. And of course, they're dancing there amongst the trees, the dancing trees.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the first Christmas tree was in 1605 in Strasbourg, Germany.
Yes.
Of course, now the tradition, I think, just about everywhere in the world.
In the Northeast, they trim their trees with strings of popcorn and cranberry.
Sounds good.
Another great Christmas tradition, the Christmas stockings, really began in the early Victorian days.
And we got a few reindeer here. All right, here you go. Can you name them all?
Oh, boy. Gummy, Tummy,
no,
Yummy.
No, no, no. Rudolph,
Mummy.
Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, and Blitzen.
Chico, Harpo,
That's right.
Charo.
And they're led today by Rudolph, as usual. Snowmen out dancing with some of the little children along the way, all down Main Street. And there he is.
Oh, yes, Santa Claus.
The star. You know, have you been naughty or nice this year?
I've been mostly nice, I think, with occasional gusts of naughtiness.
There are the Glockenspiel girls.
Playing their Glockenspiels, as luck would have it.
All right, but not only is Christmas a time for Christmas trees and presents, it is also a time to stop for a moment and count our blessings.
And remind us of the true meaning of Christmas, that of peace and goodwill to all. Two men who we count on for that spirit of hope and peace are with us today to share with you a very special Christmas message. I'm proud to introduce to you the President-elect, Mr. George Bush, and President Ronald Reagan.
Barbara and I and the entire Bush family extend our warmest holiday wishes to everyone around the world enjoying the fun and fantasy of Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade. I can't imagine a better way to capture the magic of the day than with the Disney Christmas, a family Christmas full of childlike wonder and fantasy. As we celebrate the holidays, as we share our joy and laughter with family, good friends, and neighbors, let's remember that the message of Christmas is one of peace, of hope, of togetherness. During this joyous time of year and throughout the new year, may God bless you and all your family. From all of us in the Bush family, happy holidays.
Nancy and I want to share with you our very best wishes for a happy and loving holiday season. This is the season for good cheer and merrymaking, for getting together with family and friends, and for gathering around a tree and exchanging gifts. And yet, with all the happy bustle, what we're celebrating, what we're remembering, is a silent night, a moment when angels sang glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. This promise of peace, this message of a love, has shone as a sunbeam of hope through the ages, a declaration to all humanity of the gift of God's love and of the life that can yet be here on earth. And so, in this time of year, as you hang the holly, as you step under the mistletoe, as you decorate the tree, as you, your friends and family, sit down for a holiday turkey dinner, we in the Reagan family say, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and God bless you.
Enjoyed watching as much as we've all enjoyed being here. And for my family, Michael, Sarah, Lindsay, Jamie, and of course Minnie and Mickey and everyone here at Walt Disney World, have a Merry Christmas.
Yeah, thanks everybody for joining us here today. We've had a terrific time.
We hope you have a great new year and that we'll see you here next year. In the meantime, to my boys Brendan and Robin, I'll see you in a few hours. And don't open those presents yet, okay?
And to everybody, Merry Christmas!
Accommodations for talent and crew provided in part by the beautiful Buena Vista Palace, your fun-filled vacation hotel inside Walt Disney World Resort. Air transportation provided by Delta Airlines, the official airline of Walt Disney World and Disneyland. Delta loves to fly, and it shows.